Current physical material seems like a mystery for lots of artists who used to work with the Corona material in the previous versions of the Corona renderer. For this reason, today I will solve this mystery and I will explain how to use this new material. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will show you in details how to use the new Corona physical material that you can use in Corona Renderer 7. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, let's begin with the pros of this new material. So first of all, it's more natural way of creating realistic materials than in the previous Corona material. Now, importing materials from softwares like Quixel and Substance is much easier and more accurate. And finally, you cannot recreate unrealistic materials because some options will be disabled if they cannot be used. With that being said, let's jump straight to 3ds Max. I've prepared a simple scene with some sculptures, so we can easily see the material's characteristics. I've applied the default Corona physical material to all objects. Let's start interactive rendering. Here we go! Now, if you want to use the old Corona material, you still can, but in Corona 7 it changed its name to Corona Legacy material. So you can see that it's exactly the same as it was. However, as we have new better material available, we want to use the new one, right? So we have this basic options panel with new options. I've already shown you lots of presets in my video about the Corona 7 update. I put the link in the corner if you haven't watched it. Anyway, I show you a couple of materials in case you haven't watched that video. So let's start with aluminum brushed. Let's try brass brushed. Nice. Maybe some copper. Let's see gold yellow. At the end, some plastic. It's a cool option to have such presets, isn't it? Okay, let's go back to default and I will start explaining everything step by step. First of all, we have a new option, metalness. We can choose if the material is non-metal or metal. We can start with metal first. So we have this base layer panel. We have level and color, and this works the same as before. One means 100 of color. The difference is that now, color in metal materials defines color of reflections, so we don't have to worry about setting a diffuse color of metal. We only control a reflection color. So we can make them darker or brighter. We cannot see sharp reflections because we have roughness value set up to 0.75, which means that our reflections are quite blurred. In general, roughness controls the smoothness of the base layer surface. The value 0 gives a completely smooth surface, which gives sharp reflections. So now, we can change the color of reflections so you can see how it works. Now, more towards the value 1, we create a rougher surface that causes more blurred reflections. So 1 is a completely rough surface. And again, we can control the color of reflections to achieve different results. We can use level, so 0 means 0% of color. We can of course choose color for reflections as well. You can see that we have IR disabled. It's because it's metal, so the value is automatically set to really high value. We don't have to worry about it. Now, we have bump here and we can use a map. In metal material, we can also add edge color that determines metal reflection color for rays hitting the object at grazing angle. Let me change it so you can notice what is changing. Then we have anisotropy of glossy reflection highlights. It's the same as before. Backgrounds, fluency, and refractions are disabled. So we have most of the options in metal material uncovered. Opacity and displacement work is the same, but let's go to something totally new. Clear coat layer. The thing is that we don't have to separate glossiness for reflections and refractions. We have roughness, which influences both. So if we want to have glossy refractions and more sharp reflections, we can use clear coat for this. But we don't have any refractions now, so this clear coat layer can be useful if we want to create a protective layer over the paint that is used in cars, or a coat of varnish over wood. So to turn it on, we need to change the amount value to higher than zero. Here we go. We can choose an IRR that ranges from 1 to 3. So depending on the coat layer we create, we can change this value. Similarly, we have roughness and bump of the coat layer. We can control this amount to add more or less of this effect. We can also change the absorption color. So you can see that this gives more power than we had before using only one material. Okay, let me stop here for a moment because I have some big news for you. As I said in my previous video, I can proudly announce that our brand new Arvis Artist Training is live. It's special because it targets the most demanding and advanced artists. It consists of exterior images, a city hotel shot, a beach shot, a house forest shot, and a winter shot. Tons of really great and advanced knowledge, creating advanced materials, creating nature scenarios, using post-production to create special moods and atmosphere, creating god rays, using forest pack, rock clone, editing plants in graphics, and much, much more. If all of this sounds interesting to you, I put the link to the course in the corner and in the description below, so go and check it out. Okay, so let's go back to 3ds Max. Okay, so now let's talk about the non-metal materials. Now, color is a diffuse color, not a reflection color like in the metal materials. Let's turn off the clear coat layer by setting it up to 0. We can try different diffuse colors. I set something bluish. And roughness works the same. The higher the value, the more blurred the reflections. IR is from 1 to 3, as in real life for non-metallic materials. Bump, the same. We can add the noise map, for instance. I will copy it to the diffuse for a moment to set up the size. Okay, it can be like this. Let's unplug it from diffuse. Here we go. Works nice. Let's go back to the main material. I reset the anisotropy. We can set the refraction value. It's pretty straightforward. Opacity, displacement work the same. Now let's turn on clear coat layer. Here, the same as we did in the metal material, we can change the parameters. We can make it more or less rough. We can control the amount of this effect. We can also have a separate bump to the coat. Now, if we would like to do a clear glass, we just need to change the color. Set roughness to 0. Set refractions to 1. And we need to turn off the coat layer. By increasing the roughness, we create frosted grass. Okay, so we can see that we have lots of control and it's easy to understand. And lastly, we have sheen layer. This is what makes fabrics look like fabrics, with a different look at grazing angles, in particular things like velvet. So we don't have to use a fallow map now. By increasing the amount of value, we turn on the effect. You can see it here, for instance, or here. We can also increase the roughness of the sheen layer. If we choose velvet from presets, you can notice that they use this effect. We can change the color as well. But let me show you the difference with and without the effect. Big, isn't it? And now roughness. I show you different values. Okay, so we have everything explained. Now, I'd like to highlight that we also have more options in maps, and the naming is a bit different. So, first of all, we have the new map section for clear coat and sheen layer. The old displacement is this place now. Base bump is our old bump, so it's the bump for the base layer. Let me show you one last thing. If you scroll down to advanced options, here you can change different options, and you can, for example, choose what roughness mode you want to use, roughness or glossiness. So if we change it to glossiness, you can see that it's automatic instead of roughness. And the value changed as well. Before we had 0.6 and now it's 0.4. It's because glossiness value is 1 minus roughness. In case you need to change it, you know how to do this. I hope all is clear and you are ready to use Corona physical material without any struggles now. Thanks for watching. If you found this video useful, please like this video and subscribe to the channel. Also, don't forget to check out our brand new advanced exterior course that will help you to get to the totally new level of 3D art. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!